fire.
It's four-leaf clover. Make a wish.
Wish you weren't so fucking awkward, bud.
No ego on that side of Hollywood, is there?
Because maybe they're just as good and we're wasting time.
Why can't you just admit it's over?
Some people are in it just for the art.
It's too complicated. It's like algebra. Why you gotta put numbers and letters together? Why can't you just go fuck yourself?
Hey now!
Welcome to Scrub Hop Talk, offering opinions in an onslaught of off thoughts. The blah blah's top notch. Sit for a minute with BDC and the chicken, mixing a split for a scotch rock.
My boys and I have been described opinionated 100 times and not afraid to dive into our minds. Talking deep inside, talk about the lives we live, bro. You know that the dude abides. Best part of my week is with the crew, chop it about the grind.
Where you go to get a chicken squat? Where you go to see the chicken cock? I'm talking about Scrub Hop Talk, and I might tell you why the chicken crossed the road.
For some bitches may have sold a name, but the show is still the same. We're here to let you know we still hella fucked up in the brain. Our views on the world got more screwed up with age, but the show's about to start, we're only here to set the stage.
Not everyone's gonna enjoy this show. Settle in.
Oh, what up, everybody?
Hi.
That was really a gimmick. I felt something up there.
It's nice.
We're here for episode number 36, like the Mafia. Oh, we should call ourselves the 36 Mafia tonight.
Has anybody ever used that before?
Oh, definitely. We're stealing that boldly and openly, but that would be mad fucking awesome.
Somebody else is using the name the 36 Mafia.
Where is the bud? Where is the bud?
What if we change it to like the Mafia 6?
Now
no one's doing that.
Well, hypnotized camp posse. Does anybody use that?
Oh yeah, no, that's 36 Mafia's group.
Oh.
What if we just called ourselves 666 Mafia?
Ooh.
Change it up a little bit.
What if we just call ourselves the awesome fresh crew of Scrub Hop Talk Radio? Welcome everybody. Yeah, this is gonna be mad. Yeah, we've got big Trox all the way from Seattle.
Boom.
We've got the chicken all the way from a coop in an undisclosed area.
Underscore.
I knew he wasn't going to make any noise. And we've got the newly deflated Troxy Cotton chilling in an also undisclosed place in Hawaii. Which we do want to talk on. And I'm chilling in the exact same place in Denver. No, I'm not. That's a lie. In Aurora, Colorado. I'm trying to front. Like one of my ICP claiming Detroit.
When y'all live like 20 miles away.
Jesus. I'm basically in Novi right now. That's what's going on.
Royal Oak.
Yes. So Farmington, we are all here and in our heres, wherever those are. You're where you are. But yeah, Troxy Cotton.
You're where you are. Weren't.
That's right. Wherever you're watching this right now is exactly where you are.
That's kind of a very fascinating thing.
Turning into like Dirty DeGrasse Tyson.
That was really good.
Yeah, kind of. It worked. That was good. But yeah, you're chilling down in fucking Hawaii. What's doing, little sand shorts individual?
Man, right now I got sand in my shorts. I was just in the ocean.
I had to bury the lead.
I didn't. I've seen some turtles today. I took a drive up to a canyon. I took.
How do you feel about turtles? Canyon.
He likes.
I like turtles. Yeah, no, actually, I had some thoughts when I was sitting out on the beach today, and I was staring at all the turtles, and I thought, I like turtles.
And, that was your prolific thought, is that you like them?
I do. I like looking at them. I like seeing them swim.
What do you stare at intently for a while and then decide you don't like?
Lots of folks.
Now that's fair. That's the only thing that could have fucking worked. That's
lots
fair.
Of relationships. No. But it's been really dope. I've seen some canyons. I've been on a kayak.
Do you think you could take a turtle in a physical altercation of sorts?
No problem whatsoever. Because the thing about turtles is if they stick their neck out, which they're going to try to do to bite you, you grab that neck, they're toast. You swing them around like a dumbbell.
You're just going to make turtle toast out there?
You make turtle toast.
I mean,
you swing that turtle right into the earth. It's no problem.
As far as violent animals and aggressive animals, the turtle is basically like the one-sided Rubik's Cube of the animal kingdom. It's insanely easy. A child could destroy it.
Well, okay.
Is the one side
minus the snapping turtle.
The animal kingdom.
Give the snapping turtle its due, because
the snapping turtle is the equivalent to a super glued Ruben.
That's basically
impossible to fuck with.
You can't get one side of that shit. No,
you can chip away at it for an hour and a half with a butter knife, but you're not gonna win.
No, they're basically like dinosaurs. No, turtles are obviously very easy to deal with, but there are tons of poisonous snakes, jellyfish, jellyfish? Sharks.
Yeah. Jellyfish?
Are you down there with that uncle?
No.
You getting jellyfisted?
Where is Uncle Jelly? No.
It transformed into that.
I say fist with a double S because it's fun that way. I just like to have fun when I speak. But no, there's them. There is sharks. And all of them, I think I would have a difficulty dealing with in a physical altercation, but I still would be able to handle myself. That's what I'm trying to say.
Huh, okay.
Yeah.
That turtle thing was possible.
You're so full of shit.
No, I did go to a canyon, and I did get on a kayak, and I drove all over.
Be careful with that one. Nice.
I'm happy for you, man.
Were you in Waimea Canyon today? And I'm really jealous about that.
I took pictures with your little parents, and I'm going to post them on the gram later.
That place is the dopest. That's like the dopest spot I've been to on the planet.
It's like the miniature Grand Canyon. It's like if you took the Grand Canyon and miniaturized it and then put it on
it just be called like a big canyon?
It's called the Waimea Canyon. It's really nice.
I feel like if they're going to just go with like three letters, they should have used B-I-G. It would have been more appropriate.
B-I-G Canyon.
Yes.
I'll probably go back there. I still got a couple of hikes to do. I got a few more days in this joint. I got to go out and hike the lands and swim.
Got any of that Hawaiian trim, if you know what I'm saying?
Have I swum in the swam?
Have you been drinking some of that like Hawaiian local alcoholic beverages?
Yes, I have definitely swum in the Hawaiian waters.
Who hasn't swum there?
In the Hawaiian trim? Totally, yeah, definitely. No,
how is it?
I was gonna say no, you haven't.
It isn't.
The closest action you're gonna get is tomorrow when you choke a turtle.
I've just been trying to choke a turtle all trip, honestly. I haven't been able to focus on
turtle. That's definitely got to be a new innuendo.
I hope that's a euphemism that I
yeah, exactly. That's yeah.
I got back to my hotel room after the beach and just choked my turtle for a little bit.
That's smelled good. Like dirty fish. It was kind of hot.
Yeah.
Dirty fish. Tasted like a dirty foot. Fist. Yeah.
That's that whole joke. My dick might not be 12 inches, but it sure smells like a foot. I don't have a clue who said it, but I laughed real hard when I heard it.
Hey, big ups whoever wrote that joke, because that's funny.
Big ups. But yeah, it is amazing out here in paradise and shit. What's it like in all of your undisclosed or disclosed locations?
I'm in paradise every day, baby. I don't need to go somewhere with my parents. I don't got to get a getaway trip with my ex-girlfriend I used to live with. That's a mom joke. Just in case anybody out there didn't catch the subtlety of that one.
It was subtle.
Yeah, you know, my paradise over here is great. It's really lovely. Sure. Everything's awesome. It was like 67 degrees here today. So, you know, it's great. Thanks for asking. I feel great. Thanks for asking.
How many times in the past week have you been puked and or shit on?
Oof. Let's go 24 hours and I'm saying 3.
Oh.
You guys are already back to having sex? You gotta let that heal, bro. God damn.
You gotta be careful, man.
Man, we were counting down and my wife let me skip a couple, but god damn, you guys are champions. That's because I've always said, my boy Big Trox, he is cock strong, people. I've said that for years. I've been letting the world know. Hashtag that motherfucker. Put that in the description.
I'm gonna for sure. Clip that. That's clipped.
Clip number one.
That's what I'm saying.
He's like, he just totally gave my cock a lot of praise and honors. Clip that.
A lot of pride.
How about a little bit of pride or praise for this cock in the sky up here? What's up with you?
Just a cock in the sky.
Sometimes that's all you got to be. You're like a Christian.
This is good. This is fun.
This is
who's got that kind of money?
But yeah, so he's you're chilling. Come home safe. Get back. But yeah, have fun, and we'll see you. You should have brought your banner. That's my only real criticism. I think you.
Yeah, it. I could just like get a Sharpie and write "Scrub Hop Talk" on the wall.
Do that right now, please, God.
I would love that.
Please do that right now, Big Talker.
I guarantee your name.
If
is
you
not
can't do that, you can't even choose a turtle.
You didn't put
on this room.
You did not put a credit card down. So I'm
not
saying
a one.
I'm gonna pay for that. Trox's little parents, fuck them. When are you gonna see them again?
Yeah, no. I mean, is there something that takes Sharpie off a wall? Can't you just Windex that?
Yeah, your deposit. That's good.
Yeah, you already put that shit down, dog.
Yeah. We're spraying a lighter. We'll get rid of it in no time.
Yeah,
just film it so we can put it in a fire segment next week.
Yeah, maybe just some Axe body spray in a lighter. That would be good. I forgot that for this show.
You're just going to kind of fill your hand and throw it at the wall. You're going to be every segment.
Like my hand on fire and then just.
You'll be our fire segment, our death segment, our pissed off mom segment. You're going to be everything in one.
You're going to be what gets episode 36 removed from YouTube. So thanks a lot.
You're going to be Katy Perry. Wait for it. Because of you, you're going to kill the 36 Mafia.
Oh,
Juicy J, he went a different way. That should have got a better pop. I really enjoyed that.
I thought you were going to say because I'd look good in a couple with Orlando Bloom.
Okay, so we know my what thought you're is that Cotton, you should just edit out the last 2 minutes because this is really floundered. It's not good.
Floundering. I'm not going to do it. You take it, and
I want to show you guys like. A couple dudes that spit bars.
Family. Let's watch these, bar spitters.
These guys are spitters for real, and like they put together some good stuff. So I want you guys to check this out.
Yes, churi chapati ram puri baikor pipe gun shotgun hatte loya chol golite golite pola pipe kore shor kejap korte gele hala shob dae tor tar chira matha gorom amar pistol load abar bari pura daka asi murti dot boy jokon ek at
are those like bugs?
Bees. Bees.
He's got
bees. Oh my god!
Like, I didn't know if he was mumbling or rapping. But
I too have who a threw company. The bees?
You that think that was the Wu-Tang diss?
Yeah, no, the Wu-Tang Clan was pissed off at those guys were trying to spit bars in their territory, so they were like, "Wu-Tang killer bees, we on a swarm."
And they
went after it.
God, yeah, damn. That. Excuse me, I love this confidence. I thought something like, I don't know what I thought was going to happen, like a wave was going to come in or something, but not a wave of fucking bees. Bumblebees and shit.
You know what's funny is I cut about a minute off because it keeps going where they just keep getting attacked by bees for another minute.
Okay, and it just goes because the phone's there and they can't go back and get it.
And you just hear them like, oh, God, bees.
Like,
that's great.
I don't know. Part of me is like not a put on. I believe that was probably real.
I don't think that was a put on.
Because they're not stung bees. But
I
like,
agree with you, JDirty.
Every day at that same place or something.
I thought that was going to be a tsunami as well, for sure. It looked like the type of
like
setup.
Water was going to come in and engulf them or something. Yes, I did too. Or carry the phone away.
Something good. Well, but it was just bees.
Well, that was still good.
Hit you with the bees.
I like bees.
Bees.
Beads.
Yeah. Oh, they were bees.
Okay. We're going to just keep doing this. You gotta go to the next thing around.
we're like in a state of arrested development over here.
Here, you know what? This will make you laugh.
We are farmers. Ed Robin. I have a structured settlement, but I need cash now.
I want to dance with somebody. 877 cash now.
Did the girl get it right? Because I was very distracted by him.
The girl was singing the right thing in the background while the guy was like, I just want to dance with somebody.
Like some old Paula Abdul shit. Like, I need somebody to love.
Yeah. Meanwhile, the chick in the background saying, call J.G. Wentworth, 877 cash now.
So she did do it, right?
Oh, hell yeah.
877 cash now. Do you think we'll get flagged for that?
877
cash now. We're going to get flagged for playing the J.G. Wentworth commercial.
Yo, straight up, it's in the commercial. He's going to score that money.
He's getting that J.G. Wentworth money.
Sorry, John Gerald Wentworth. We did not mean it.
Is that for
John
real?
Gerald? Sure.
Did you make that? Oh, okay. I think it's John Goodman, actually.
Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt Wentworth.
You remember
John
that dude?
Goodman Wentworth.
We had that dude Kosher on Socially Awkward a lot.
Yeah, I remember.
The guy he had a whole
the guy
record.
That tattooed his eyeballs.
Yes. He had a whole record called like J.G. Wentworth.
I remember.
And the whole video was ripping off that song. So my guess is we're fine.
Yeah.
Dope.
Yeah. I mean, I hope. J.G., we're just playing.
Hey, Koji, we appreciate
come on the
you.
Show.
It's free we advertising. Like your, fuck off.
Yeah, we did that.
We like your advertising. That's why we sing along.
We had them on. That's fine.
It's you should give a bonus to whoever wrote your fucking jingle, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. For I don't sure. think it was Kosher.
Probably wasn't.
It was a
I don't even think
jingle?
It was a Jewish guy that wrote it.
Wow. Wow.
For Kosher,
wow.
You can't say that anymore. That's not even remotely bad.
No, it's not.
You can say that if it's about hot dogs.
Or pickles.
So remember that dude that I played last week that was busting out all those sweet dance moves
and never touched his feet on like dance in the dirt.
Yeah,
that dude was mad fresh.
I got something new that's kind
of
like that
of him.
No, another dude. But this
he has a YouTube
also
Tower of Dudes Part 3.
This is Tower of Dudes.
You gotta phrase it like that.
This is definitely Tower of Dudes 3. Here you go. Oh yeah.
Uh-oh.
He is way bigger than I anticipated moving
I know.
Like that.
He looks like Cotton on episode 4.
He looks like Kim Jong-un.
I think I saw this guy on the beach today.
Holy shit. Whoa.
What? Look at that.
Whoa.
Look at him. Look
How
at him.
Do that?
Wow.
Look at him. He's so yeah. much person.
And fuck everyone there looking unimpressed. The splits were a little, like, hurdy. But, like, no
How
one there seemed at all impressed.
How much does he get to eat to stay that size and be able to do that?
Lots and lots of hot dogs.
You know, but what if that size actually helps him? Because he's doing a lot of rolling and spinning. And if you're more shaped like a ball or a marble or something like that, that might help your momentum.
He's not
yeah,
rolling.
But if you're doing that,
like he wasn't on the
ball or a marble.
If you're doing the practice to get that good at it, you know, you should lose some of that fat ass.
But he's got that marble midsection. That might be good.
But if he was a skinny guy doing a dance at a competition, no one would be talking about it.
I think there just aren't enough fat breakdancers for us to really know this for sure. I think if there's more fat breakdancers, we could solve this riddle.
We've got this and the guy that, like, the fat guy that's like, here, hold my gun. But that guy wasn't very good.
That guy was good, though. He was not bad.
He wasn't hold like this gun. Guy.
The hold my gun guy was not bad. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
No, that was fresh. I'm just saying, those are like our two examples of fat dancers. And the hold my gun guy was only funny because he's like, here, hold my gun.
Yeah. But so, okay, hold on.
And he wasn't this big.
I'm starting over because watch the way that homie comes into the shot. Like, that's the most impressive part. Like, he starts out like, check me the fuck out, okay?
Come in hot. Woo!
Oh, hot. He's like, I'm springing right off the back of my neck, fam.
When you first turned it on, I just thought he like did like a like surprise fall intro, you know? Like, I didn't know that was part of it. Look at this. Look
nice.
At this.
Man.
That dude's nice as hell.
How is that possible? Those are the strongest wrists in the game. Like, I'm fatter than that guy probably, so I'm not hating, but like you don't expect that kind of agility.
Do you think his wrists are stronger than Otis's?
I think a toothpick's wrists are stronger than Otis's.
Toothpicks have wrists?
We love the Otis. They grew them.
Think up.
Hey, yeah. I used to come put out flyers that made that joke. It's fine.
I know. That's why I went for it.
I don't think that's what's going to keep him off.
Yeah. No, I don't either. I think that, you know, let's check him out one more time.
Yeah, dude. Big fan.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Get it. Yeah,
I love right. the stuffed Pokemon in the background, too. I'd love to compare him to the Pokemon.
Boss it.
God
Boss
damn.
It. Boss it.
And, like, for real, hardly anyone looks phased. That little kid's like, y'all watching this? The splits is just kind of like, wow.
Yeah, wow.
Impressive.
I've fallen sort of in that position, and it hurts. He did that on purpose.
You've been in that position?
Oh, you've never – come on. You've accidentally slipped and, like, never that low, but way too low for me.
I do that stretch in my bed every morning. I just kind of, like, I wake up on my stomach, and then I, like, throw my body out like that.
Gotta get that morning fucking in,
this
right?
This is floundering.
Interesting.
I don't like that you guys keep on calling me a flounder.
No. Well, hey, we have a very special guest joining us tonight. Before we bring him on the air, I want to play a little something, a throwback.
Is this the chicken's real father? Will.
Yeah.
Throwback Thursday?
This is the chicken's real father.
We found him.
I'm going to play a little something that JDirty put together for the Juggalo show back in, what is this, Jay? 2006?
This would have been 06, yeah. Late 05, 06-ish. I can't remember.
So this was created by JDirty.
One of the voices on here is joining our show this evening.
That's right. That's right.
We'll tell you who in like 30 seconds.
Yo. All right.
Maybe like 40 seconds.
Yo.
I offered to help.
This is all staying in rehearsal. It's all staying in for sure.
Strange music with Juggalo J. What's up? This be the one them called Tech Nine, and I'm kicking it with my homeboy Juggalo J. Yo, this be Chris Calico with Juggalo J. What's up? This your boy Bloody Cutty Cal, baby Kutt Calhoun. Kick it with Juggalo J all day. Yeah, yeah. Yo, this is Mikey Clark. You're listening to the Juggalo Show. This is Prozac. You're on the Juggalo Show. Yeah, this is Scatter Man and your boy Snow. And you're listening to the Juggalo Show.
This your boy Juggalo J reminding you to tune in Thursday nights from 9 to midnight.
The Juggalo Show, 91.1 FM, KWSB, baby. You know I'm sizzling, we do it real big. Tech Nine?
That is crazy as shit to rehear.
What's up?
Without further ado. Yeah, I was going to say, with the voice on that little thing you just heard that is joining us tonight is the one and only Bloody Cutty. Kutt Calhoun, welcome to Socially Awkward. Or that's we just heard it. Welcome to Pop Talk. That's last time you joined us. That's fucking hilarious.
Hey, yo, what's up? This is Bloody Cutty Cal, man. You kicking it with Juggalo J. What's happening?
Yeah, you're doing great, man. Thank you for doing that for us, like forever.
Mr. Black Gold, welcome to the show, man.
Oh, man, thanks for having me. I appreciate it, fellas. What's popping with y'all, man?
Man, it's great to have you.
Doing our show, we like to, you know, reach out to people that we have been following, admire, like to just keep an eye on. And, of course, we've been – that right there is 15 years old, man. We've been following you forever. It's crazy. Yeah, that was back in 06.
That time went like that, didn't it?
Oh, yeah. Fuck, man. It's insane how fast it went. Excuse my language. I see a little man in the corner.
No. Ain't nobody in the corner, man. That's you're supposed to be in bed. It's bedtime.
Like, I feel like I'm cursing at a child. I'm sorry. We've just been following you forever, dog, and it's awesome. You're still rocking it, and we just wanted to kind of touch base, see what you've been up to. You know,
appreciate
what's up
with
Mr. Black Gold, like he said.
Man, you know, as everybody know, man, I kind of was on a hiatus after 2016. After Cut Loose came out in 2015, I went on a solo tour. I was fortunate enough to go on, and then I went out again in 2016, and that went well. And then, you know what I'm saying, man, life hit me, man. I got into some situations to where I had to stay home and had to get my life right here at home, man. You know what I'm saying? It got real serious here at the house. And I was just I took a long hiatus, man. I mean, from social media and everything. And then I 2019, I put out the Truth Be Told, man, which is like one of the most vulnerable albums I ever did, man. I ain't never really let nobody into my life.
It's real personal.
That in depth, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I did it because it was, you know, it was just put on my spirit to do so, man. I, you know, along with that time off and get my family together and get my marriage together and stuff, man. You know what I'm saying? I had a life-changing journey, man. It was on my spiritual journey, man. And so Truth Be Told was from a spiritual standpoint of my maturity of where I came from to where I was going, you know what I'm saying? Hence the song, Where You Been, is more like where I'm going. And so still kind of been on the hiatus of that, man. But it's like I ain't been really tripping. And then not too long ago, I mean, and in between times, you know, I've been doing verses for people and whatnot. I've still been doing the annual discount for verses for, you know, some for fans that's, you know, maybe always have wanted to do something but never really had the proper amount of cash. And so I drop it down to like $500 for people that so it's affordable and stuff. So I've always stayed in the loop, but not necessarily was, you know, worried about putting out music like that until here of late. And I made a post on Instagram saying that it's time, you know what I'm saying? And, back to get back at it, you know, calling all producers, and you know, that's kind of where I'm at right now at the present day.
That's awesome, man. Congratulations on the whole getting the family right, because none of this means nothing unless everything's good at home, and we all represent that. So that's what's up right there.
No, and right. You know, truth be told, it's fantastic, man. It's a great record. It, you know, just takes me back to, like, you know, everything that I heard from Kutt, from, you know, Black and Gold to it really felt like old school Kutt, and it was really dope. But then I'm like, all right, so you put out this awesome record, you got that tour. What has the last 2 years been like? Because I mean, that's, you know,
right. The last 2 years, well, hell, you know, that came out, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, May 7th of 2019, right? And so, of course, I didn't tour off of it. I did a couple of shows here locally, man. About the furthest I went was probably, you know, three and a half hours, I think, up to Wichita to do a show off of the Truth Be Told album. And, I kind of did some songs that I've done in the past as well. But it's like, okay, and that ended in the summer. And then it just kind of just smoothed away, and then boom, we got hit with the COVID-19 early 2020, the beginning of the year. So, we was just kind of living, taking it easy, man. You know, being cautious like everybody else was supposed to. But that time, and all of 2019 for real was a quarantine time for my wife and myself. Anyway, before we had to be quarantined, I was already being quarantined. You know what I'm saying? I was getting my shit together, getting my life right. Because it's like the past that I had, if you listen to Truth Be Told, I mean, you kind of know all you got to do is listen to the song Truth. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I was dealing with here at home. Like, that had been over years. But, you know, man, you can't put a time clock on or healing time on recovery time on pain, you know what I'm saying? And so I had to go through some things, you know what I'm saying, that I had caused, and I had to just deal with it. So that was why I was like, music was on the back burner for me. You know, music is me, you know what I'm saying? It's in my life, it's my life, it's what I do, you know what I'm saying? I eat sleep shit music, you know what I'm saying? I breathe it. But I had to put that on the back burner, man, and make sure that, you know, my wife was right. I had to make sure that I built my trust back up with her, man. It was just more important to get her right and my family right, and to let them know that I'm on the up and up than worrying about some music. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of like what that was. And so we was quarantined. We wasn't going nowhere. We wasn't doing nothing. We was here. We're listening to sermons. We're reading the Bible. We praying together. We having good days. And then out of nowhere, we having, I mean, pit down in the pit days, and just had to go through the roller coaster of emotions and life dealing with what I did. You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot to come with that, man. A lot of fans is like, where you at? Where you been? Y'all ain't know it. Hey, dog, if y'all can feel what I'm feeling, you understand what I'm talking about and why I've been away from the scene for so long. But, you know, that's neither here nor there, but I'm here now. And, it, you know, by God's grace, man, everything's all good. My family's good. We're good. And I'm ready to get back at it.
That's what's beautiful. Up, man. Yeah, you mentioned the fans and everything wondering about you. Anybody that does care and has been following is going to be happy as hell to hear what you just said. Because, again, none of this music matters without that. But I went on Facebook today, and I didn't say you were coming on necessarily. I just said, hey, who's fucking with Kutt Calhoun? Man, I had over 100 comments, over 100 likes in like 2 hours. So many people like, oh, man, fuck yeah, I do. I have so many. I still every day, you know, a bunch of people threw questions. I mean, they're still waiting, man. So I know everybody can't wait to hear what's next and watch you.
That's what's up, man. I put out that post on Instagram about a week ago, man. And like 2 days, a day and a half went by. I looked at it and I had like 3,800 views already and like, 60 comments. And I'm like, you know, that felt pretty good. Like, okay, yeah. You still messing with me, man. A diehard fan, or should I say a true fan of an artist. It don't matter how long of a hiatus an artist take. If you're a dedicated fan to that artist, you know, you'll wait the 10 years. You're going to live your life and you're going to do your things. And when they come back out, it's going to be right back like you never missed the beat. You know what I'm saying? So much love to all the fans out there that still stuck around. That lets me know who the true dedicated fans is, man. You got people that just kind of like a fan of yours through default. You know what I'm saying? It was a lot of fans that was just, I fuck with Kutt because he's on stage with Tech N9ne. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It wasn't because I fuck with Kutt because, man, I just love Kutt's music. And so it's a good thing to go through what I went through, man, because had I not did what I needed to do and started my own label and break away, you know, I would never know who my genuine fans really is. And so to be able to see that and then those fans stick around and to even gain new fans from that, man, that lets me get my stamp in the mud of who I am and my genuine following. You know what I'm saying?
What you built as yourself and everything. That's super fresh. So on that note, what is that next whole, that venture? You're talking about the new music, you're coming back. I know people want to know. That was the number one question. That and about an old Impala. We'll get to that in a minute. But everyone, what's that new record? You know, what's the new sound?
You know what, man? It's like it's so much new stuff that didn't transpire from from 2016, 2017, even 2019 to right now, man. And I've always been a person that's like, you know, times is changing and I'm listening to the radio or I'm listening to stuff on YouTube or I'm listening to new music, and there's a few things that I like because there's some people out there with talent, but then it's always been a lot of stuff out there. I'm like, come on. So, you know, with that being said,
we very much all feel that.
So with that being said, man, I'm like, okay, when I had that epiphany, like, it's time to get back at it. You know what I'm saying? I just felt it in my spirit, like, it's time to do something. Make a post. I made the post. I seen people messing with me. You know, they fucking with your boys. So I'm like, all right, cool. Now, call it all, producers. I'm getting emails, people sending me stuff, and it's cool. It's like not what I'm looking for, though. And I really don't know what I'm looking for. I just know I wasn't looking for that. You know what I'm saying? Right. It wasn't what I was feeling. Yeah. And so I ran into somebody, man, and I just tell you this. All I can say is that I got the beats yesterday, and going through them, listening to them, and I picked every beat, and I got every beat, and I came up with every title, me and my wife listening. That's never happened before. I picked the beats the same day, got the beats the same day, came up with the song titles and wrote a hook all within two and a half hours. And so
for every song on your new record.
For every song that's never happened, fucking crazy.
Props on that.
Sounds like you got some pent up energy to make some music, man. That's awesome.
Man, I'm telling you, I don't know what it is. It's something pent up in there that it's time to be unleashed. You know what I'm saying? I got my vulnerable and my personal stuff out of the way. Now it's like, get back to Kutt. You know what I'm saying? Back to that Kutt, but a new and improved version. You know what I'm saying? It's still, I'm talking about back to Kutt. You know what I'm saying? Everybody talk about that blevy Kutt or that, you know, that raw and uncut Kutt. And I was like, to myself, I've never lost that. I've always felt like if you don't evolve, what are you doing it for? You know what I'm saying? You hear them sayings like, you want my old shit, buy my old album. You know what I'm saying? Because people, you have to grow. But I know what they mean. They want that that same energy because, you know, every album got to be better than the last one, man. And I felt like I've grown over the years through each album better than the last one. And you're going to have your diehard fans that's like, people still talking about, I love Buck Rock, bitch. And I'm like, man, you know, like, damn, really? Out of all this music, but, you know, to each his own, man. And so, this time.
I think that's what I meant when I said to you that, you know, the truth be told, reminded me a lot of your old, of the old cut. It was just because it had that energy. Like every track just sounded like it sounded like you had that same energy that you had 10 years ago. Different beats, different flavor, different kind of, you know, different soundscapes, if you will. But it still sounded like Cut coming at you. And that's what I really appreciated about it. And I'm like, man, I think you still you have that. That kind of energy and that aura where you could just bring in some new producer, new beats, and it will still have that same old energy that you have. Yeah, the cut sound. Yes.
For some reason, guys, I don't know, man. I couldn't tell you. I don't do it on purpose. I just feel like every time I put out something, regardless if I'm evolving or growing or not, I feel like it's my first album that I'm working on. And when that goes away, then maybe you need to step away from music, but that's how it should be. At least that's how it is for me. Every time I approach an album or project, man, I write it and I give it the energy as if it's my first time. Like that's how that hunger stays there. You know, you can listen to some people, you know, over the years, and then you start going, well, shit, man, they don't sound like they used to, or they ain't putting the same caliber of music out, and you know, ooh, they kind of fall and they slipping. When it starts being like that, then it's time to back away and it's time to just swallow your pride and just back away and be like, maybe my heart ain't in this no more, but man, my heart's in this all the way. My heart's body, soul, spirit, all of it, it's in it, man.
Yeah, boy. Well, I know we're not going to get a lot of details on the album necessarily, but is there like end of summer, fall, Christmas type of like time frame, or is that still also up in the air?
I'll tell you this, man. I guess
exclusives here, as if you can't tell.
Right. Oh. The timing of it is going to be all up to me, I guess. You know, I'm in control. So, like I told you, I've picked beats over time. And as I'm waiting on more beats to come in, I might finish a song or two and then some more beats come in. But at this particular time, man, like I said, I got all the beats yesterday, bought them all, and came up with titles for them all, wrote a hook. I know who I want featured on songs. I'm only going to have like three features on the whole thing. Ooh. But here's my thing. What I did realize with this day and age is that albums, this is what I might have to do for the dedicated fans, for them day one fans. I might have to press up some hard copies because they love the hard copies. They want it signed and this and that. But what I have noticed in this new age, man, is that people putting out singles versus singles. The whole album, because it's like the whole album gets overlooked because the attention span of this generation is just like, you know, they get it and they listen and then they on to the next thing. And you like, you know, you got some quality music right there that's being looked over, man. And so what I'm going to do is I will be putting out singles, but it'd be from the album. You know what I'm saying? And for those ones that like to get press it, man, it's gonna be locked and loaded.
You know, not to in these days, you need to just, you know, skip the CD, put it on vinyl and cassette. That's all you need. That's all anybody. You don't need a CD anymore. You do a digital copy, a vinyl and a cassette, and then that's all you need to do. You're
right, man.
Then you got your collectors, and then you got your, you know, the people that just want to listen to the music.
Yeah, definitely, man. So it's going to be a new marketing approach for me. You know what I'm saying? I will say I got kind of spoiled with being over there with Strange, you know what I'm saying? Just having stuff get put out and the way that it gets done. I got kind of spoiled with that, but you know, I don't mind changing with the times, but still remaining me, you know what I'm saying? I'm still going to be me, but I'll maneuver the way that I'm supposed to maneuver this marketing thing. That's what's important. The marketing part of it, you know what I'm saying? How it gets out to someone and you know, the masses that it can reach, depending on how it gets marketed. You know, the music is going to speak for itself, but you could have the dopest album in the world, but if nobody knows about it, what you going to do?
The same conversation we have every week on this show.
Too, the whole marketing approach that was of the past kind of is gone in a way, because we don't have the record stores. Like, those are fucking unicorns in every city. We all have one, but they're not 20 anymore, you know, like it's just changed up so much with
the digital. And for, you know, the new release rack is now one end cap instead of...
They're all vinyl, like you just said.
Yeah,
which is super dope. I love it, but it's crazy the evolution of it.
Now it's all about having that, you know, that Friday release, getting a release radar on Spotify. And that's all it is anymore. You know, there's no physical media anymore. It's wild.
Right. I know we're slightly approaching like our time with you, but I had to ask multiple people in that thread of questions asked me about this custom Impala. It seemed to be, I thought I knew about you, a 96 custom Impala that they made it seem, the look on your face tells me you don't know what I'm talking about. Like these people made it seem like it was some real big deal. And I'm like, oh, I'll have to ask him.
The Impala, it was a modified. I sold my car, man. It was my baby, and I never really even got to enjoy it or whatever. I had a black with red race stripe down the middle. It was a 96 Caprice Classic, but whoever I bought it from, it used to be a police car. It was modified into the Impala, the 96 Impala. It was modified into the Impala with the engine and everything. And I had it painted all black with the red race stripes down the hood and down the roof in the back. And I had the inside custom done black leather, red suede dashboard, red suede and black leather interior with Kutt Calhoun on the headrest or whatever of the both front seats and whatnot. And
I love that at first your face looked like you didn't know what I was talking about. Then you're like, oh, my name was embroidered on the headrest. It's got my nut hair in the floorboard.
That's my poker face. That's my poker face.
I was like, man, these people asked this question like it was a big deal. I'm like, I don't think you have a clue what I'm talking about.
Yeah, yeah, no, man,
that's fresh. Okay, man. That makes more sense.
Yeah, and I put pictures out there on Facebook and all that stuff, man, and on eBay as well. On eBay as well, yeah. And a fan. It was a fan that stayed a little bit past Topeka, and he came down here, man. He bought it, paid for that's it, so and cash. Yeah, it was.
Really I will let everybody know then, because I thought that was hilarious. And then for a minute, I was going to be like, man, were y'all trolling me with that question? He's like, I only had a bike. What are you talking about, motherfucker?
Yeah, that was the Bloody Cutting Mobile, man. I'm telling you. Yeah.
Bloody Cutting Mobile. That's what's up.
Oh, man, now your poker face is amazing, homie.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of time to practice it, man.
That's funny, man.
That's funny. Just to piggyback on something you said a couple of times, because I do know you mentioned when you're talking about this album, calling all producers a couple of times. Are there any of those exclusives, any of those that you might be able to give us right now of like a beat from a producer that you're for sure thinking is going to be on the album and is ready
to go?
Oh, man. I could let you guys know, but I'm not.
All right.
I could let you know, but I'm not. Only reason is because it's so soon. It just happened yesterday, man. But I will tell you this.
Here we go.
I get a couple of songs done in the studio, and if, you know, you got my email. We can do another one of these just to give you guys an update, and I'll play a little something. But I can't do it so soon.
We'll make it happen.
All I can say. Well, before I say this. Any one of you guys, what's something that you really wanted to ask me and you like, oh, fuck, I ain't gonna ask Cut that, man. He ain't gonna want to talk about it. Now's the time. Go ahead and get it off your chest. Whoever got that
the
million.
The story in the verse on Groupie. Was this made up?
The story in the verse on Groupie. Is it made up?
Yeah. Because we had Chris on the show years ago, and he goes, that's probably real. I don't fucking know. I don't remember that song. I was like, damn, that's like my favorite collab of the three of you forever.
I'll tell you this, man. I've always been a guy that wrote a lot of, you know, what I was going through. That kind of gave me the lyrics to write it. But that particular one, let's just say it's 30-70. 30% of it's real. And then 70% of it is my creative mind.
I'll take that. So there's remnants of real life. We'll take that.
Yeah, 30-70, because you know you got that that ghetto love. Remember that song? Won't you do that ghetto love?
Yeah.
Oh, hold
yes.
up. Okay, that was all from my brain. None of that stuff happened. Sex Out South. None of that stuff happened. You know what I'm saying?
I figured that one was kind of fabricated, but yeah.
I mean, yeah, we make music too. We say some crazy shit, but yeah, it's real shit. So
what it is, man, a mixture of past experiences that you kind of just you using some things that you've been through, but you're adding to it with creativity. That's all. You know what I'm saying?
It's like an audible spank bank. I like that. We'll take that. Yeah, that'll work. That's going to be the quote for this week.
Any other questions, man? Because I got like 2 minutes left. Any other questions?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm not going to sit here and ask you about why you left Strange. I think everybody knows that. You know, we've all seen the interview on Facebook and YouTube and that kind of thing. But after all these years, I mean, it's been 6 years now since you're gone. Do you still maintain relationships and friendships with the people that you were with there on the label?
I'll tell you this. I've talked to Tech over the years quite a few times. Never got to see him. I've been up to Strange Music. I've talked to Travis. I've never got to see Tech, but I've talked to him. We've texted and I've talked to him over the phone. And, you know, I talked to him recently, you know what I'm saying, when he was about to get a new place. And he was kind of close to where I was staying and this and that. But I haven't spoke with him as of late. I've talked with Calico quite a few times. Haven't seen him, but had the communication over the phone, you know what I'm saying? And recently here, I've talked to my dude, Stevie Stone, you know what I'm saying, congratulated him on his new journey and whatnot. And, you know, I've talked with Stone, and that's probably about it. Tech, Calico, and Stone are the ones that I've talked to, and Stone is the most recent one.
Wow. That's,
yeah, props to him, too. He's out doing his thing independent again, and that's super fresh, too. So, hell yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, so I know we play real quick. I know that we played a stinger that you recorded for us 15 years ago. I got another one that you did for us about 10 years ago. So
yeah. And then we will let you go.
And then we'll let you get off the show. But I want to play this one for you right quick. So here's the one that you did for us.
The evolution of you on our radio show.
This was for Socially Awkward Radio on NFN.
They know we on NFNradio.com.
Yes, sir.
They know Kutt Calhoun, Kansas City Chiefs in the building. They know BG Boulevard in the building. Right. They know we got shows coming up Sunday.
Uh-huh.
But what they didn't know, man, is I want to give a big shout out, man, to the Socially Awkward Radio Show with your host, JDirty and Big Trox, man. It's going on Sunday nights from 6 to 9 p.m., man. If you don't know about it, you can hit them up at www.nfnradio.com. And I just wanted to throw that in there, man. Yeah. I'm gonna need like $50 for that. It's going on, man.
I got 12 cents.
I respect Dirty. You got that done.
I make shit happen. Show.
Wait till Sunday.
I make shit happen.
I'm taking shit over my head.
Mouth don't get fed. You know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah, man. We just wanted to play that again, too. We actually opened for you at those shows that you were promoting.
We praise you. So,
yeah, man. We've been fucking with you a long time, and we appreciate your time.
Yeah. Thank you so much for doing this.
I appreciate you guys. Thanks for the opportunity. And like I said, I'm a man of my word, man. Hit me up with an email here, you know, in a couple of weeks, man, and we'll do this again, and I'll definitely let you guys play something out here for everybody. So I just want to say before I get off, shouts out for the support. Shouts out to all the fans, the dedicated fans, man. Hey, shouts out to the people that's come and to the people that's left too, man. Everything is made me who I am right now, and I just. You know, I just thank the Lord for it, man. And I thank all of y'all for y'all support. And all I can say is this year, I'm back. Kutt Calhoun, baby.
Woo! Woo! Bloody Kutt Calhoun.
Man. Well, we're excited to see you. Welcome back. Stay safe, man. Congrats on all the fucking growth, musically, family, everything, dog. Congratulations.
And we're going to take you out tonight with your track, Money Talks, off Truth Be Told.
So, yay, yay.
Bloody Kutt Calhoun, Money Talks.
A deadly sin. Make a strange nigga whip you senseless with the pistol. They call me the shot caller. Known to get the party started, get faded. Mark's my barber. Soon as I speak, my reach spans for miles. I meet somewhere discreet where no weak man's allowed. I got the power to shower with Halle Berry. Devour every soul in your house if it's necessary. And I'm known to get back niggas when kidnapped. Just make a phone call to where your kids at. It's fucking real. I wage wars and mingle with the worst of men. Get involved with me, believe I bring the horses in. The police is always out to get me. But I'm protected by the government because of my contacts, and I ain't never told on a one yet. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. I hang with the rich, they always wanna see me because they greedy, never wanna let me go. I know about they secret faults and who they sleep with, mistresses and seen the vaults to where they keep it. I know murderers, politicians and escorts, made an athlete shave points so he can get endorsements. I got pool with Hollywood celebs, talk Kevin Hart into wearing a wig and dress. See, when I'm around, shit goes down that you don't see, cause if you did, you go bleed. I'm well connected, got easy infected with HIV. Damn, talking too much. And to the feds, I ain't nothing but a number. They wanna track me so I can lead them to a come up. I know too many people, just say the company that I keep ain't God fearing at all, the evil, y'all. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. I was the source of the heist in LA, biggest ever. City of angels ain't a good place. I fuel drugs and death with BMF. Ask them brothers about me, they say I played big stakes. Guess it's my temptation that amazes. My alias Franklin keeps them all engaging. I'm sought after cause of what I do and how I speak that makes them wanna stick by me. Trace my roots, go back to 700 BC, and you can see the trail I leave. I've been locked up, spread it, threw in the air, shredded, blood stained and can't forget it, embedded. But I will always be your closest homie, the one you love to hate when faces get put on me. Some cling and others they run from me. In case you missed the name and recognizing the game, it's money, 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 money. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. People love me cause the way I talk, the way I look, I'm just another big head crook. The envy of all people, for rich or poor, you find me and I give you what you adore. People love me cause the way I talk. Money.
Should someone have to have a government-issued license to drive a car?
Hell no.
What's next? Requiring a license to make toast in your own damn toaster?
The license to drive? You know, I'd like to see some competency exhibited by people before they drive.
Boom!
Were those
Boo!
Bad lip readings?
No, that was...
That was real?
Yeah.
Were those like those brothers from Howard? Like those?
That was the Jesus like twins, Chad and JT? No, man.
Not the Jesus twins, the stoners that are like, we're mad.
Yeah, Chad and JT. No, it was not them. This was a libertarian debate. And
that was real?
Yeah.
That play it real. Again.
And the cat. You'd wish that this was an SNL skit. It's not.
That's what I'm saying. It looks super fucking like SNL-y.
It's not.
Should someone have to have a government-issued license to drive a car?
Hell no.
What's next? Requiring a license to make toast in your own damn toaster?
The license to drive? You know, I'd like to see some competency exhibited by people before they drive.
That, why do I know that middle guy? His voice is Johnson? Super familiar.
Gary Johnson, I know, because Gary Johnson's run for president multiple times. And that's
a few times.
And he's the guy that's like, I'd like to see some competency. And everybody's like,
no, the guy, his voice is crazy familiar. We don't know him from something else. Like,
That's not. I don't think that's a bit. I don't think that's a put on at all.
No. I don't either. I just, his voice is very, very familiar. Like we've seen it in a movie.
Maybe he's a debate actor. Maybe he's like some type of actor that they use in like these debates or like crises or something like that.
I'm not planning a put on this time.
You just told him.
But yeah, that guy's voice was familiar. I'll find out why, or I won't. I say I will, and then
I won't. I'll do it or I won't. I don't know.
Tonight I want to do it, but by the time I watch this on Sunday, I'll be like, I don't give a fuck.
This one just made me, you know, I see lots of videos of bird things, and I'm just like always.
I do not appreciate this segment.
I'm always drawn to bird videos for some.
Yeah, me too.
I don't know what it is, but
so much fun.
This one I really liked, and I
thought anxiety.
Oh, there's something happening in my videos. I don't know what's happening. Oh my god!
Bird, I got rid of two of mine. They just
moved
up.
We're not time stamping this too.
Here you go.
Stupid fucking asshole.
Fuck that guy. That guy's a dick.
Yeah.
Big dummy. Nothing.
Like, no. I wouldn't go on that. I wouldn't even go to that city. I'd rather be on the boardwalk at that time with food on my face.
Go I wouldn't go to that city. Fuck that city.
You've like, never been they got to birds. The boardwalk.
They have that's not birds? Just birds.
No. Fuck that.
Like when I watch like the Rockies play the Giants and like during like if a game goes late, those seagulls are fucking like they come in while you're still walking out to get all the food and shit. Like come 9:30, it's terrifying. It's fucking horror scene.
They're shitting on your face, regardless.
Well, that guy, I don't even know what should have happened. Like I was scared that he was inviting a bird to his face. I didn't even expect it to shit on him.
I wish that more animals would have come up and shit in his face. That guy's an idiot. Like if a squirrel would have just run up and shit on his face, and then a chipmunk, and then like a pelican flew over him and shit on his face, and then just
pelican and a bird are the same thing.
Not exactly. Pelicans are way bigger and they're way stronger.
You said all different animals, and you immediately
we're talking about like a gull versus a pelican.
Calm down, Noah.
Dude, pelicans are ruthless. You ever seen a pelican eat a duck?
I have. You ever see a pelican shit on someone's face?
We should watch some of those videos. I think we could watch those.
Do you guys think that we can play like pelicans eating duck videos on Scrub Hop Talk?
Those videos are actually pretty nuts.
That's mostly what I watched.
Back to the lunatic that we just watched. I don't appreciate things like that because it's insane.
Maybe that's all I have to say. You know, anytime I'm scouring the interwebs for videos, these are things that make me think of you.
I want you to know how not alone you are, because anytime apparently anyone I've ever met in my entire life that knows I'm on Facebook sees something about a bird of any fucking kind, that's all I get. My whole interaction is people sending me fucked up bird videos.
I'm sorry.
And Preach sends me weird best man videos. I don't know. I think he's getting at something, but he hasn't asked yet. but, you know, like everybody sends me fucking
Big Preach. What's up?
Fucking bird clips. And I'm like, God damn it, I hate everybody.
I like that. I like
Big
that.
Trox, Big Trox, it turns out D does not like this segment. If you could go ahead and stop doing this segment for D over here, we would appreciate it.
Keep doing
it.
The segment for Done D. And you love the D. Yes,
we are on fire. You want to run this piece of shit to the ground. Nice, but stop putting the aviation fuel on the cocksucker right now.
I don't know, it just burned down all its own.
Propane.
That's your fucking reckless, boys.
That new
and here
dope.
We go!
Let's just get right into it.
That's that new flaming country.
The music keeps going.
Wow. Well, that one was an overlay.
Oh my god, can we do that again? I really like that one. Yeah.
So they're pouring like alcohol on it.
Something. Yeah, something real flammable.
Was that a heavy metal concert with like a cowboy bar back? Or like, what the fuck was that guy doing there? I don't understand.
That was Billy Ray Osborne.
Well, I called it Flamin' Country, and I thought that could have been the name of like that Lil Nas Billy Ray Cyrus song. But yeah, I don't know. That shit.
Can explain how he took the stripper pole down to hell
on fire.
Just saying.
So I missed this guy last week in my fire hand segment. The look at the end is the fucking best look ever.
Wait. When he started, he had a shirt on. Then it looked like he threw his jeans. Why does anybody upload these things?
It clearly didn't work out. And he's like, I'm uploading that. That looks good.
It may have been like a live.
Oh, my God. One more time. The sound on that when he's waving his hand really makes me laugh. I love that.
Oh my god,
that's funny as hell.
That's the best. That's real good. This fire segment is getting better and better, boys. I'm sorry I ever asked for it to be shorter.
Yeah, you're doing a good job, chicken.
Okay.
Oh no, that's not good.
This is called drunken hubris, overestimating your athletic ability.
Bro, he fell backwards into it.
That's Troxy Cotton trying to fight a mountain.
Troxy Cotton trying to choke a turtle.
Oh my goodness gracious. I would choke a turtle while jumping over a fire way better than that guy. That was absurd. Don't compare me to him.
Oh, wow.
I'm choking a turtle while jumping over a fire? That's extreme.
I am marvelously dexterous compared to that guy. And I will get over that fire.
Wait, marvelously dexterous?
That's correct.
Holy shit. Holy shit.
Yeah, that one's fucking nuts, man. That's intense.
Let's see. Any of you guys ever own a Zippo before?
Oh, yeah, bud.
Yeah, obviously, like a lighter.
When I was a cigarette smoker, I was a big Zippo guy. I was all Zippo all day.
Well, here's all a Zippo refill
all the time.
Don't refill your Zippo this way.
Oh my god!
she's pouring it into the container.
Yeah, you're not supposed to do that.
You put that on the cotton. Oh fuck.
Oh, my God. Holy shit.
Oh, I'm backing up sitting here. Look at it all blowing up this house.
Why are you still light it right there?
Don't do that.
The table was saturated in lighter fluid.
That was her son's desk, the family dinner table, and his bed at nighttime when they put it down.
That double wide is gone, fam.
Yeah, that whole house on wheels is out.
Their Murphy bed took away the whole trailer.
I'm not even going to fact check it. I'm just going to hope you're right.
Oh, it's right. That was Murphy bed. Yeah. That was quality. I like that.
Do you guys like sparklers?
Oh, you dick.
Whoa.
Oh, my God. Holy shit. What just happened?
That guy ate a sparkler.
It's Tapas. He's at a fancy wine bar, and he wanted a snack.
And everybody's always telling you, like, snakes and sparklers are the way to go. Sparklers are, oh my God, you guys ever take it like 800 degrees, man.
You guys ever take a bite of food that's, like, still really, really hot, and then you gotta, like, chew it for a second to, like, and, like, open
it up? You gotta, like, eat it like a seagull.
Yeah, then your tongue hurts. There's no way that dude didn't have, like, blisters on his tongue.
Yeah, no, he's dead, He's dead now.
He just eats everything through a straw.
His esophagus tore, and he swallowed blood until he died. He's dead.
I think you've seen way too many Final Destinations.
How many videos have you been watching on the internet?
Yeah, I know. You've been doing too much research for this show.
our research department is getting really jaded.
So there's no young children around them.
Yeah.
You asked about this one recently, Dirty, and so here you go.
This is a suicide vest. Oh my god, it's only got one. Oh.
I've never not loved that.
Why, people? Why?
I laughed so hard because he knew. It's not like it was an accident. It's not like he wasn't sure what was going to happen. He knew.
Yeah.
And that's what makes it so amazing to laugh at.
What an asshole.
Fuck that fat fuck. But it just is upsetting to see him do that because I just think about me when I was a fat fuck and that happening to me. And I would hate it.
That guy's like 27. Like, he's of, of some intelligence.
Wow.
Or should
you think someone who is of intelligence because they're 27?
I'm just saying, it's not like he was a little kid. And just for the record, not for the record, but just to go on record, can you please use the phrase, give me a challenge right now? Because I just don't. And I think we could have a lot of fun.
I'm not going to put on a suicide vest. I have too much sense.
Didn't that guy, Chicken, also have a video of like him jumping into like cactuses or something? I feel like I've seen that guy get hurt.
No, you're thinking of the I know exactly what you're talking about.
That's the backyard wrestler guy who jumps into shit.
Yeah, that guy.
That guy.
Not the Juggalo kid.
Yeah, the Juggalo kid. Yeah,
No. I will actually do research this time. I think there's more videos of that guy doing really dumb fat guy shit.
He strikes me as the kind of guy that would do really dumb fat guy shit.
Yeah, you know, I love what?
That category. We should type into Google dumb fat guy shit and see what comes up. Because
I definitely see a description coming in.
It's a subreddit, I'm sure. Is that the last one, Chicken?
That's it. That's what I got.
That's all you got.
Oh, hey, I appreciate you playing that because that video has always made me laugh.
All right. Well, I hope you
like a pretty cool outro or something like
that. I hope you enjoyed the fire segment. There you go.
We should play that to like segue into other segments.
That's what that was. That's what just happened.
But since the fire segment's done, I wanted to you know, we were just talking about how Troxy Cotton's a big fat fuck. So this made me think of you.
What's the choice?
You're right.
Bring your hand around. You still hurting me.
Harry, stop struggling and it's
I'm not struggling at all.
He can clearly see he's not struggling, so it's all fine.
Mate,
loosen your arms.
What do you expect me to do? I'm fat as fuck, you prick.
I'm fat as fuck, you prick.
You still work for me. What is the situation going on there? Who are
you? I wasn't sure why it reminded you of him and then his face turned. It just reminded me of Troxy Cotton in the intro.
I hate you guys. I was interested in finding out what was going on in this clip, and instead I'm being berated and abused.
Yeah,
I you're titled, not. We're just comparing you to somebody that is.
I just titled that one "Fat as Fuck," and so
what did you expect from me? I'm like, fat as fuck.
Like, I did no research on that clip. It didn't feel like it was necessary. It's just a guy who's fat as fuck.
Yeah, when he said he was going to play a clip that reminded me of him, you thought he was going to like be nice or pay homage or something.
Yeah.
Have you seen the show before?
No shit.
Hey, I wanted to talk to you about how like you've been doing really good things health-wise and how you're feeling really good about yourself. But instead, I'm just going to call you a fat fuck. You can't even get arrested properly.
I dropped a considerable amount of weight, and then you start off the segment with, hey, I thought of this fat fuck and made me think of you.
On Facebook, I am very proud of you. We're not here to puff up your little ego.
Hey, social media, bitch.
I will text you personally and be like, hey man, big ups, good job, bro. But then on this show, you're fodder.
Hot Rod Magazine, pal. Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, we're proud of you because you'll live longer because you were in a bad place. Like, watch your intro, like your verse in the intro. Shit was not going well. Like,
that was just a few months ago.
Yeah, I'm not even convinced that this is a diet. I think we should be cherishing our final moments with you. Like, if you shaved your head, I'd be like, it's over.
I've actually been in treatment for about 8 months.
Yeah. Okay, you gotta play something. Trip with mommy is your fucking payoff.
Oh, you want to play something? All right, here, I got you.
This is my make-a-wish.
This is a holdover. You'll like this. Check this guy out.
Because you don't fucking know. Because you haven't read a fucking book, Scott. Have you? Then what's the difference, bitch? When I asked you what the difference was, what's the difference? If you spent your whole life reading, what is the difference, Scott? There's a lot of differences. Okay, so you don't have an answer for me. So you sit down in my space while I'm with my fucking friends and you ask me this shit. He knows he has to leave. How dare you?
I need you to leave as well, please.
I have to leave as well.
Yes, please. Thank you.
I mean,
I like how he's shocked. Oh, he knows I'll leave he as well. Has to leave.
Fine. Great. No, it was like it was a question. I have to leave as well, but it was in the same tone, like the same register. I have to leave as well?
He just thought she was on his side. Like, he was like, oh, he knows he has to leave. Me too?
Scott knows. Scott doesn't know much, but he knows that he has to leave.
Look, he's picked this up by now.
In the beginning, I thought the kid sitting there, for one, I was like, why is that new age like kid wearing a Marlboro red hat?
Yeah.
For weird reason.
I have the same
like, he got that from Free Points from 37 years ago. Like, I don't under or miles or whatever. But anyway, I thought that kid was getting berated by his father. I didn't realize it was behind him. I'm like, he is staying stoic and not getting affected. And then I noticed what was really happening. But yeah, I thought it was one of those videos.
I think it was a bit of a lover's quarrel, if you know what I'm saying.
You think Scott?
Oh, that was not. That may have been an ex-lover's quarrel.
Oh, you think?
Yeah, you think you can read, but you didn't read the last message when you dumped my ass.
Yeah,
you know, like that. There was some definitely Dick's Ben here aggression in his voice.
Poor Scott.
You can always tell
Dick's Ben here aggression.
Oh yeah. Like, you ever watch Jerry Springer? It's like all over.
But, you don't have to explain it to me. I know Dick's been here aggression. Trust me.
I bet you do.
He's filled
every time
it.
You get mad on the show.
Oh, my God. I love that one.
That, I enjoyed that one.
Yeah. This has been a great clip. I would even venture to say we're having a good time.
Oh, I'm having a great time.
Are you having a good time? All right. Well, hey, let me keep that going here. This guy is also having a good time trying to have a little late night treat.
Okay, meet me at the bar in 15 minutes.
What the fuck? Hi, Claudia. Okay,
put on.
I don't know, bro.
Put on.
Into the oven for me.
That guy, he couldn't hold the pizza up, and he ended up dropping everything.
We've been way drunker than that. Every one of us, and done dumb shit.
I've never fallen over for that period of time before or into an oven. Listen, he was falling.
Yours
for like
ended up in jail. Shut the fuck
yeah,
up.
It was
you,
a
guys,
different.
You guys.
Yeah,
have
he burned his ass
me.
A little bit.
You guys have pictures of me looking like I could be the guy that dropped the oven on myself just now. So that, oh. That to me is like that's totally possible.
I watched
we've
you.
All done that. Yeah.
Yes. I watched you try to open up your house door with your cell phone, thinking it was a key, but this wasn't one of those like smart doors or nothing like that.
I watched it, you tell Cotton you didn't key. Know that I didn't know where I lived, and then you told him how to get lost going to my house, and I was so mad.
That was fun.
Why the fuck are you listening to him? He's like, drunk. I'm going home.
I insisted on giving the wrong directions.
From the back seat, and this fucker listened to you. As if I didn't know where I lived.
So I empathize with the guy that could not get the pizza out of the oven. I feel like he's trying to live his best life. He just wanted that Totino's. I have wanted a Totino's so bad before that like I could see myself folding in the oven to get a Totino's.
My roommate in college came home once and woke me up by calling me a dumbass because I put a Totino's in the oven and fucking passed out on the couch for 3 hours. That bitch like curled up and like turned in like a fancy guy's mustache. It was fucking so burnt. And then our trailer was so smoky. So yeah, I've been there. I just didn't call in the oven.
Wow.
I really enjoyed that.
Big up to Merch Ben.
That was Merch Ben.
Thanks for saving my life.
Big up Merch Ben. We miss you. And we love you.
He's still with us.
No, that's why I said that we love him.
We just can't play shows for him to sell merch.
No, we definitely can't. Here, I got another thing to show you. This is fucking crazy. Here.
Yo, look at this fucking bullshit. What the fuck? Do a flip!
Oh my god, do it again, do it again, do it again.
Yo, look at this fucking bullshit. What the fuck? Do a flip!
Oh my god, how Detroit. High is that guy?
Absolutely, it's Detroit.
So fucking high right now. That's crazy.
Oh my god, like,
oh man,
the amount of fucking meth or whatever the fuck you gotta have. Your body.
Run oh, that guy's dust,
down the highway.
That guy's dust as fuck right now. That's all dust. That guy. That. Yeah, he is just dusted to the floor.
What
does
dusted mean? I don't know.
PCP.
I don't even actually know what that means, but I don't have to get into it. I know it's I was gonna say like from Friday.
It's embalming fluid.
I was in the fucking pigeon coop, man.
You don't like to get wet.
It's embalming fluid. It's like what Denzel Washington makes. Ethan Hawke smoking training.
It's not like
day.
I had a gun to your head, motherfucker.
Yeah, that's that shit.
I rewinded. You had a gun to my head.
Like,
it's, that guy is amazing. That guy is a ghetto Olympian.
Yo, look at this fucking bullshit. What the fuck? Do a flip!
Ah! I get so happy every time.
He's just he's running. He's just running. And then he stops and he's like, fuck, I'll do a flip.
Like, what so else? Cool. I would have kept doing circles and running back. Like, I don't know. What else do you say? It's like,
somersault.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I'm not sure what the names of gymnastic tricks are, so I can't really share
that. I know. I set that up like I had references. And
triple
I don't.
Sow cow. That's skating.
Yeah. Yeah. Crisscross applesauce. I don't know. Like yelling some shit at him. I told you that was Detroit.
Yo, look at this fucking bullshit. What the fuck? Do a flip!
That's a fanny pack, right?
Oh yeah, I mean maybe. He stopped.
Oh my god,
that shit was fluid as fuck.
Yo, look at this fucking bullshit. What the fuck? Do a flip!
He's wearing like some Tarzan loincloth bullshit.
He's barefoot.
Look at this fucking bullshit.
That's amazing, man.
Yeah, that's awesome. That is definitely the truth.
So much.
I'm glad we got to play the clip for it because definitely.
Yeah.
So
do a flip.
God damn.
Я нахуй скину сейчас сам, блядь, отсюда. Скидывай, давай. Прыгай, ёпты. Мне вообще похуй на тебя, блядь.
Толкни меня!
Sometimes man. You really need a cigarette, man.
Oh my god. That guy
was like, give me a cigarette or kill me.
So push me off or give me a fucking smoke, bro. Like
if I don't have a cigarette,
either
I
way, cigarettes
die.
Are killing that guy. Yeah. What I got out of that.
I mean, gravity might beat the cigarettes to it.
Holy shit.
Oh no, absolutely.
That was really high up.
I don't
can
know.
Can we see that again? I just wanna notice how high up that was because it was. That's very
really
high
up.
It's high up as fuck.
I wish somebody would have gone, do a flip!
We're talking like six story. Like that's...
Hey, you mouth fucked. You fucked up a fucking touch. You mouth and jump me then.
Jump off. I don't fucking care about you.
I don't fucking care about you.
It's not like they were homies. That wasn't Nick Jackson.
He's
you're
like,
not getting a cigarette from me. Jump off. I don't fucking care about you.
Wow.
You might as well be dead now because I don't give a fuck about you or your plight.
Which, if he really didn't give a fuck about his life, he would just give him a cigarette. But like, you know, he's not going to do that. He's just telling him, "Fuck you, I'll push you off instead."
Do you know how expensive cigarettes are? Cigarettes probably 50 cents a piece.
You know how cheap it is to do that.
Yeah. Man, back when I smoked cigarettes, they were like $3 a pack, and you'd be like, yeah, you can have a cigarette. But now they're like $75 a pack. You can't do that.
Like, cigarettes are like, what are they in New York? Aren't they like $12 or something like
oh,
that?
Oh, they were $12 in like 2004.
Yeah, decade ago.
I think in New York, they're like 15 to 20.
Easily. Yeah.
You're probably
How much are they in Colorado?
$8 minimum nowadays.
Is it illegal to send cigarettes?
The minimum they can
the
charge for a pack of cigarettes now. What's that?
Is it illegal to sell cigarettes in the mail?
Gotta be.
I don't know.
Yeah, there are probably laws against that. I'm
like,
damn,
probably.
We should take this off.
Yeah, because you gotta have tax stamps on it.
No, I'm not gonna do it if it's illegal. I'll keep it on there. This may have been the very first promo for Jay Smokes. You know what I mean?
No, we need a lot of research done by next week. Yeah, we BDC Smokes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm not keep it on the air. I'm trying to.
We'll mail you Lucy's.
We got that Scrub Hop Talk tobacco. We're ready to get it pumping. You know what I'm saying?
We got Newports and Marlboro Reds. Just put it in the comments.
We should keep this off air because I was going to do this as like a solo venture.
You guys ready to sign up? Let's do this.
You don't bring a cane to a fucking fist fight. What is that guy doing?
Is that a fucking battle royale?
No, that guy was on IR from the last game.
That was insane. Like,
there'd be
what
two
is
dudes
that?
In the middle, like beating the shit out of each other, and another guy runs up and just kicks him in the fucking head.
In the noggin. That's a full blown battle royale to the death, it appears, in the middle of a Russian forest.
Wow. Those are all brothers, and the winner got to fuck the sister.
This is the annual ceremony in Dagestan. Is that what you're saying?
Dagestan. I like that one.
That was insane. I don't know what the fuck was going on, but
murder?
Yeah, exactly. Murder. In my old age, I'm done wanting to get punched in the face.
Definitely someone got
You had times when you wanted to get punched in the face?
There was times when I got punched in the face frequently because I had an older brother that watched fucking Steven Seagal and Jean-Claude. I feel like we've discussed this. And he'd come home and beat my ass. But getting punched in the face sucks.
Yeah.
Shit hurts. There's nothing fun about that.
I think the kicked in the head is the real tough one. That's the one that gives you the concussive.
They all started out up, though, with their fists up. They all expected to get punched in the face. I'm just saying, fuck a fight. I'm very passive these days.
Yo, we're not about fighting here on the Scrub Hop Talk. We fight with our own.
Don't worry. About an hour ago, I called this socially awkward radio, so it's fine.
Yeah, you told Kutt Calhoun that he was on socially awkward.
I was so used to hearing that shit. I think I don't know. Like I played it 2 weeks ago. I got hyped.
We've done 36 episodes of this. We've done more episodes of this than we ever did of socially awkward.
And the last one of those aired in 2012. So. No real reason. I'm just saying you can fuck up.
Oh, what a great.
Yay, yay.
Oh, man.
This has been a wild episode, fam.
Guys.
It's been a lot of fun.
That interview was a lot of fun, okay?
You know what? I got several more videos, but I'm just gonna I'm gonna play one more to take you fuckers out today, because this shit is just crazy. This could have probably fit into Russian Detroit, but we're gonna play it right now. Okay,
most of our videos could.
Yeah, most of them could. Check.
Wait, are we not fact checking?
Okay.
Whoa. No.
This is Fast.
Oh,
they're filming for Fast and the Furious 11.
Oh God.
Yeah.
We didn't play that before?
No.
You said, I don't like this kind of shit.
I thought he was going to get, hurt, crippled under a car or something. That's fucking awful.
Did you do any research on that? Or was
you
that
remember
just
Lethal Weapon 4 where they're fighting on the highway? And I was always wonder what would really happen. Like, that's what would happen.
That's what would happen.
They would fall out immediately. End scene.
Yeah. Tuck and roll.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, that's definitely what would happen.
You get that's fucking nuts. Bad. You ever get your shirt ground into your skin before? Because that's what is going to happen here.
See, the thing that, so I did look into the, like, in the video, it said that the person in the car, they were trying, like, there was an altercation earlier, and they were trying to jump through the window and fight the driver. Because that's how you do things, right?
The, like, the tagline alone is like, wait, why?
Yeah. It did. It clearly didn't work out. The driver in the other car got away just fine, and this guy ended up on the fucking highway. So
have you ever been that mad?
Yes.
No.
Yeah, yes, I've been that mad, but it didn't exhibit itself in this way. Yeah. Like I was.
Chicken's been that mad before, just at us before we start recording.
Chicken was that mad at us 2 weeks ago. At no, we were like, "Hey, are you ready?"
And he gets mad for 10 minutes and joins us. No, I don't. I just don't even fucking know. That is some immense anger to have towards somebody. To like, I'm gonna jump at him on the highway.
It's the most immense amount of anger.
Like if that happens to me, I get mad and I turn on "Die, Motherfucker, Die" loud. Yeah, like to volume 10 because I'm old and it hurts now.
It's a good song.
You know what I mean? And I rap like I'm angry at these people. But old ladies have guns now. I'm not getting in an altercation in my car. That's how you die.
Old ladies have guns now. Stupid. Is what we should title our next album. Old ladies have guns now is dope. You know what
I'm
saying?
Putting the word guns in our next album title.
Why?
I don't know. It's almost like you want to kill a puppet on a record.
Oh,
that's
great
another gathering. Life. That was Detroit.
Okay, we can't keep doing this.
Hey, so we do need to go, but I've been packing up everything because I'm moving my shit. And
we all know you're packing.
Oh, big time. And I found this. It's hard. I'm trying to. That's weird. I've never done
is
that.
Is it a cookie cutter of your head?
Yeah, I was gonna say I've never done that before, but it's like oddly like.
It's like your whole head.
Anyway, you remember doing those tracks?
No. What is that?
The chicken was right, and I still have.
We made JDirty cookies. I remember that.
I found these in a box, and of course, I'm not gonna throw them away because I'm me. But
is that thing petrified?
No, it's so fucking fragile. It's ridiculous, but it does.
But is that moldy?
No,
that's crazy as shit, dog.
Yeah, we gave them away at one of the release parties. Like
I remember,
maybe dummies. But I just thought they were fresh. I've been finding some old cool shit that I'm actually gonna start sending some scan some shit and send over to you, Trox, to play on to put up on the show because I've been finding some cool old early. JDirty big truck shit.
I love it.
So, but yeah, I found those. I'm going to pack them back up. So I wanted to show those on the air and they weren't going to make it past this week. So
I'm all about appreciate that action.
That.
Yeah. There's just some dope shit coming at you. Cause behind me, everything's empty, but we'll get onto that at later times. Yeah. My shit starts looking weird.
I didn't bring it up on this week's episode, but yeah, it's obvious your background is very different this week.
It has morphed slightly.
Yeah.
We can talk about it on episode
and 37. We will
37
or 8 or 9 or 40. Who the fuck knows? But anyway, hey, y'all, thank you guys.
Hey guys.
And super shout out and special thank you to Kutt Calhoun for joining us tonight.
We love you, Kutt Calhoun.
Yeah, that was dope as fuck. I don't know. I haven't seen an interview like we said since that old the one that he put out on Facebook and shit. And I don't know. That was 2015. Dope.
So we are the best thing that's happened in the Kutt Calhoun universe since 2015. Thank you.
In the form of an interview.
Thank
go
you.
Check out his 2019 record.
It's really good. It's really good.
Yeah, but yeah, thank you for coming on the show to him. Thank you guys for watching and listening and supporting us every week. We appreciate it. Big Trox, Chicken McFatballs, the newly deflated Troxy Cotton.
Ooh.
Oh, I thought you were trying to say something. And myself, JDirty, we appreciate you guys. Scrub Hop Talk. We will be back next week right here at scrubhop.com every Sunday. Thank you guys. Peace.